In this lesson, we will play with the Settings API. The Settings API allows you to access some settings that are not visible in the graphical interface, in the backend. So we are going to see how to use it. So what you need to do first is going to the addon store and activate the API access addon. You will notice a new tab now when you edit your sections, the JSON tab, where you can see all the parameters that are used to manage the section. When you're customizing your app, what you do is you are setting up parameters that are described into a JSON file. And here on the JSON tab, you have a graphical view of how this file is structured. In the backend, it's merely impossible to display all the options you can act on to customize your app. That's why we have selected only the main features you use to customize your project. But on the JSON, it's possible to modify parameters or add new parameters if you want to go beyond what's possible to do with the backend. Let's take an example here. I'm customizing the list view of an article section. I can set up the color of the title. I can choose the font of the title, but I cannot choose the font size. If I have a look at the parameters of the sections, I see that there is an entry called title font, and inside title font I see size. Here is the actual size of my title. Let's change it to 33. Save your modification. And let's have a look at the preview. You see that I have changed the font size of my titles. If you look at the API documentation, you will see all the parameters that can be modified to customize more deeply the sections of your app. Let me give you another example with the photo section. My goal is to change the layout of the pager. So I go to the documentation under the photo section and I check if I have a possibility to modify this page. Here I see that there is a hidden parameter I can activate to modify the way the pager is displayed. So let's do it. I need to add a new property called navbar title token under the detail group of my photo section. Let's go to the JSON tab of my photo section, identify the detail group and open it, and add a new property. My property is added. Now I need to see what I can put inside. Back to the documentation, I can see that this property can understand two tokens, current and total. So let's build something with this. Let's enter the property value using the tokens, save your changes, and let's check the preview. I've modified the way my pager is displayed. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time, and meanwhile, happy app building.